Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hi, I'm Hasha. Hi, Hasha. Bintu Mama Shafiq, a humble 16-year-old student from SDP Integrasi Gombak, and I'm one of the candidates for Gombak District Nilam competition. Many people strike me as a curious optimist, and frankly, such a trait had more consequences than you expect. Sometimes I would fuss at this with my endless questions, and on some days I would jump into a new passion project the moment something caught my eye. This ultimately leads to my never-ending list of hobbies. A jack of all trades, as some would say. Some to mention are drawing, writing stories, swimming, playing musical instruments, and even learning German and Arabic. But overall, I love reading the most. Be it novels, essays, comics, screenplays, articles, you name it. There's just something beautiful in having unlimited freedom contained in a simple piece of writing. In school, I consider myself lucky to be given the opportunity to represent school in a number of competitions. One of my highest achievements is winning a gold medal in an international Taekwondo Poomsae tournament and winning best speaker in an international debating competition. Debate in particular has taught me tons of life lessons. One of it is that there is always the other side to the picture. And this message is most evident in the book that I'm going to review today. Second Thoughts on Malaysia, Globalization, Society and Self is an engaging compilation of essays written by Julian C.H. Lee. Second Thoughts had inspired a change of outlook on my life. In his own words, it's about capturing those reassessments of how we think or feel about something. This book gives a fresh perspective to common narratives that we are associated with in society. It tackles many issues in Malaysia and the world. The author implores readers to reconsider quickly formed opinions. Now tell me, how many times are we so sure of a person's behavior that we think there's no redemption for it, but change our minds the moment we hear their side of the story? Basically, Second Thoughts is a book that offers skepticism without harboring cynicism towards our everyday ideas that are ingrained to cognitive biases. It teaches us to retrieve information differently, with the mindset that whatever we're told, though it may be true, our opinion of the matter may still change. My favorite essay in the book is on not following your passion, which really struck a chord with me. Ever heard that saying that goes around, oh, you should just find your passion and go for it? Well, as a person of million interests, I find that hardly easy to follow. There's too many things that I like, but hardly enough ones that I could stick with. However, the essay debunks this advice by saying that passion isn't something that you find. It's something that you come to love as you grow with it. So instead of asking the question, what is it that I like doing best? Ask yourself, what is it that I can contribute? And that really is the nail for me. This book gives me a ray of hope when everything felt bleak and taught me a very valuable lesson. Overall, if you're someone who's always open to new ideas, especially stories from the other side of the coin, I suggest giving this wonderful book a try. After all, Arthur Schopenhauer once said, every person considers the limits of his own field of vision to be the limits of the world. Danke fürs Zuschauen. Mach's gut. Tschüss.